Our verse for today is Ephesians 4:29. Let no corrupt word proceed out of your mouth, but what is good for necessary edification, that it may impart grace to the hearers. Welcome to Swordbox Ministries. Thanks for checking out the 6th video on marriage in our family series.
Welcome back. We're continuing our series on the family, and we're focusing on God's principles for a good marriage. Today we're going to talk about the big C, communication. Good communication is important in any relationship, and it is absolutely essential in a good marriage. Ephesians 4:29 says, "Let no corrupt word proceed out of your mouth, but what is good for necessary edification, that it may impart grace to the hearers." Now this verse applies to all believers, and yet so often the person we should be speaking the kindest to, our mate, with the most encouragement, we tear down and belittle them with hurtful words. You know, we're all creatures of habit, and our words can be very habit-forming as well. The other person can't always see your intentions or your motives or heart. They can only go by your actions and your words. We can even say the right words with the wrong tone and deliver a very different message than the one intended. Or being overly sarcastic all the time can damage good communication. So take time to examine the way you're speaking to your spouse and see if your words are uplifting, encouraging, and kind, or if you're pulling them down, and if your words are harsh and hurtful. James 3:6 says, "And the tongue is a fire, a world of iniquity. The tongue is so set among our members that it defiles the whole body and sets on fire the course of nature, and it is set on fire by hell." You know, when disagreements arise and emotions get high, it's so easy to let those negative, hurtful words slip off our tongues. As mature adults, we have to learn self-control, as well as being able to drop an issue until we're all calmed down and can speak to each other respectfully. The potential to encourage one another is endless. We have the opportunity to plant seeds in our mates, into their lives, seeds of encouragement to help them achieve their dreams. They may have days where it seems the whole world is against them, but yet they can come home to someone who shows that they believe in them and are for them by their words of support and even faith spoken into their lives. And not only should our communication to each other be good, but also our communication about each other should be good. James 3:11 says, "Do not speak evil of one another." I mean, you may have had a huge argument with your mate. You're emotionally drained. You're not real happy with them at the moment. This is not the time to vent all your personal matters to your friends and get them all to agree with how right you are and how awful and wrong your mate is. Get on your face before God, vent to Him, and then ask for His comfort and ask for His wisdom. But resist the temptation to speak bad about your mate. So when it comes to communicating with your spouse, a good passage to keep in mind is in James 1:19 and 20. "So then, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, and slow to wrath. For the wrath of man does not produce the righteousness of God." Once the words come out, you can't put them back in. And often we're swift to speak and we're slow to hear. We must learn to talk with our mate and not at our mate. And remember to listen. That's the first thing in good communication, is being able to listen to what the other person is saying. Remember to keep all that bad communication out of your mouth. Be uplifting, be encouraging to each other. And when disagreements come, make sure you're calm before you start talking. And that'll help with your communication. God bless you. We'll see you back here tomorrow on Swordbox.